Welcome to the locker room. Coach Giggs here in another installment and series of messages here at the Dominican Republic, Punta Cana, where our company has had its national convention and some of the greatest leaders have crossed stage and have been a part of a great event. With me here in the locker room is a very special guest and visitor who I've asked to be in this locker room. You've seen her husband, Tim Clark, in the locker room. Well, now you're going to get to hear from Elena. We say it many ways, Elena. How do we say your name? Elena, Elena, and your parents wanted to name you?
Athena.
Athena.
Yes.
Mom and Dad, I like that name, Athena, right?
Yeah.
We'll call you Athena. Just we can be anyone we want in the locker room.
The Greek goddess of warfare and handcrafts.
Oh, I like that.
Because she is.
I like that. Okay, so you have been officially renamed. Anyway, welcome to the locker room.
Thank you.
Athena, good to have you here. The title of this message, by the way, for those of you out there, is The Power of Support. The Power of Support. And in this message, Elena, thank you for being here. I got to interview and showcase your husband. And as we were showcasing him, I couldn't help afterwards chatting with you a little bit, and I could immediately see a big part of why he's so successful, because he has you there at home supporting him in every way. Mm-hmm. And when I look at and have the opportunity to get to know people who do great things, what the common thread is, you see that they have a lot of support at home, whether it's through a sibling or through good friends, or whether a mom or a dad, a husband or a wife, and that with that support, that individual can become even greater. And so in this locker room message, I guess I'm wanting you to share with everyone out there the importance of support and what it means to you to support your husband and how you go about doing this, and what advice you would give to so many others out there who are not necessarily on the front lines, you know, killing and taking no prisoners and doing all that we do, but kind of behind the scenes, really lending that support, that love. But before we go into the message, a little bit about you. Where are you from? How did you and Tim meet? You know, why were you born? All those wonderful.
Why was he born?
Well, we'll leave that part out. but where are you from? And a little bit about yourself and your background and your family and your children. Tell us
okay.
a little bit.
I'm from Cleveland, Ohio.
Okay.
And Tim and I actually met in high school. Our senior year, I called him 2 weeks after graduation, and we talked on the phone about 12 hours a day for 2 weeks, and then he picked me up for our first date at midnight, and
oh my God.
Then we just, a year and a half later, we got married in 1920,
wow.
Just had our 16th anniversary this year.
16 years.
16 years of marriage. We were babies.
Wow. In high school.
In high school.
And 10 hours a day?
You on guys? The phone, yeah.
On the phone?
Oh, yeah.
Wow, did you not want to see him, or was it?
It was just, I don't know. We really liked talking to each other.
Wow. So that's where it all began.
It did.
So now, 16 years later.
We have 3 kids.
Tell us about these beautiful children.
Wonderful. We have, our oldest is Addison. He's going to be 12 this year, who's named after my father and my grandfather. And Elijah is 10 now, and he's a black belt in Taekwondo.
Black belt in Taekwondo.
Yeah.
Ooh, I want him as a bodyguard.
And he cannot wait to work at AIL.
Really?
Oh my goodness,
he's coming into the family, huh?
Oh, he's like, I'm working there.
Love it. How old is he, 12?
10.
Can they get an insurance license?
No.
Okay.
And then our daughter is Guinevere.
Guinevere.
Yes.
What a beautiful name. And how old is Guinevere?
8.
8 years old.
Yeah.
So you have 3 beautiful children. And,
wonderful.
And you have a beautiful husband. And this locker room is all about support.
Yes.
Because Lord knows, when we see people who struggle out there, and then they come home, and they come home to either an empty place or a place where they're not getting support. People are on their back instead of covering their backs,
right.
As we hear. What does it mean to you to be a support to Tim and to your family? What does it mean?
It means, well, I want to see him succeed. I've always wanted him to be the best person he can be, the most successful person he can be. And my job, because I was, once we had kids, I wanted to be their mom. That's my focus,
right.
Now.
Right.
So
most honorable role
started,
on the planet.
It's fun. He started with AIL when I was 7 months pregnant with our very first.
Okay.
A little nerve-wracking. And, you know, but he's like, I want to do this. I want to go in sales. My dad was in sales. My dad died when I was 22.
Oh.
And he was just a great man, and my husband loved him. So
wow.
he's like, I'm going to do insurance. He got his insurance license. He did this. And he would be so nervous every morning, he would actually throw up before going in the field. I kid you not. He would sweat through shirts making calls. He would smoke a pack of cigarettes.
Does support mean that you like wipe him down after
no,
he throws
I'd
up?
No, I'd say, or? He's like, I'm nervous. I'm like, okay, good. Change, go.
Change and go.
Yes.
I like that
yes,
method.
No, I'm like, you know what? You can do this. You've got it. Go do it.
Wow.
You're great.
Wow. So support to you means more than just sitting back and when he comes feeding him a meal. It means really encouraging him maybe and pushing
always.
Him when he needs pushing.
Absolutely.
And, wow.
Anytime there's a little bit of, you know, reluctance or something, okay, go ahead, talk it out, whatever. Let's fix this. Get your head straight. Get back out, go. I remember B saying his wife would say, he'd call and done, he's like, how much have you sold? You can't have dinner and come home until you finish more. And I've always taken that role. Because I know what he's capable of. I know how brilliant he is.
Wow.
And I don't want him to ever settle for anything less.
Did you hear that? She knows how brilliant her husband is.
He's brilliant.
Oh my goodness.
So we, you know, he couldn't be home in the evenings for family mealtime, so we'd have family breakfast. I'd wake up early, we'd sit at the table, have breakfast together. Because the schedule was so different, I homeschooled the kids, so we could carve out time.
You homeschooled the kids?
I did, for several years. When he was in management, we'd meet for lunch in the middle of the day, so we could all see each other. And you know, we just structured our family around this. And,
so you're making sure, talk about support here, that you're getting family time.
Absolutely.
That you, the kids, and your husband are together, whether it's in the morning.
Work around it.
Wow. What advice, Elena, would you give to the millions of people out there, specifically to those who are more in the support role than in the out in the trenches, so to speak? What advice would you give to those individuals?
Number one is be flexible.
Okay.
And also, you know, just see your loved one for who they are and who they can be, and know their goals. And when they start wavering from their goals and they get a little sidelined, direct them back. You know, we do things like addition by subtraction, where he'd have a goal for how much ALP. So I'd put a paper on the dining room wall, I'd write his goal for ALP, and every night I'd subtract how much he wrote in the field that day. Like, okay, you have this much more, you have this much more, you hit your goal. How much more can you do?
Wow. I think we'd have a lot more million-dollar club winners if we had spouses and girlfriends and people doing what you just did. You mean you actually write out exactly what he needs to do and you show him at the end?
Yeah.
Wow. That goes beyond support. That's proactive support there. What made you do that? What inspired you to do that? You just felt that you needed to do that as a partnership with him? So I guess what I'm trying to find out is, it doesn't sound like any one of you are more important than the other. It sounds like we got real teamwork here.
We do. And it's, you know, he sometimes when he was in management, he'd come home because someone, you know, it wasn't a good fit, or he was like, I put so much time into them and, you know, it hasn't been productive. I'm like, listen, I do the laundry for 5 people. I do the dishes. I cook food. And the next day I have to do it all over again. And there's no profit from it. Right? Nothing. There's no reward in clean clothes. Yay, we have dishes. Everybody's eating, but the kids are complaining because it's this and it's not like corn dogs or something. So.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow, that is awesome. Any other advice before we leave the locker room in this image we'd give?
Just love them.
Just love them.
Just love them. Just, you know, be their undergird when they're, you know, having a rough time. Listen, let them cry it out, you know, but then pick them back up. Set them straight, turn them around.
Wow.
And go.
I honestly don't think I've ever heard a better message on the power of support than I just heard right here. And so for those of you that are out there, and I'm so glad you did this, because Elena, you gotta understand, she didn't really want to sit here in the locker room. Generally, people that are behind the scenes, they don't like the camera.
No, I'm a photographer. I live behind the camera.
You're behind it, but I gotta tell you, you need to be in front of that camera too, because you were awesome. Thanks for joining me here in the locker room so much. Wonderful having you. And for those of you out there, thanks for joining us in the locker room. Live your best life and make sure that you're getting that support at home. And there's no question, when I think about the support you're giving to your husband, he must be giving you an awful lot of love and awful lot of support
does.
As well, right?
He does.
Because you want to do for him because he wants to do for you and the children, doesn't
he? Oh, yes, absolutely. We're number one priority in his life.
Teamwork here
yep.
is making that dream work. Thanks for joining us in the Locker Room Gang. We'll see you later. Take care. Thank you, Elaine, for being here.
Thanks, Eric. Teamwork making the dream work. That's
awesome
a Mary Kay
stuff.
Saying.
What's your name?
No, Mary Kay. Teamwork making the dream work.
Oh, I got that from Mary Kay? Oh, wow. I didn't know that.
See, he got into sales because I was a Mary Kay consultant for a few years.
It makes sense now.
And he'd be like, he'd go out and be like, whoa, this didn't happen. Like, well, you know what? Some will, some won't. So what? Yep.
Who's next? Something
yep.
like that? Oh, my God.
Next.
I don't know that I've been in a Mary Kay convention, but I think I need to go to one because it seems like
they're
they've
wonderful.
Got...
wonderful.
Yes. You were Mary Kay before you got married? Or
no.
did you do that during...
During.
Just as a little something to...
I did it. I was doing well with it. And then when my dad got cancer, I stopped. And he had, he's diagnosed in 6 weeks to live, so I took care of him.
Oh, my goodness.
And then...
You took care of dad?
I did. But you know what? When my mom got cancer, Tim actually stepped down to a GA, so he didn't have such a high workload, so I could take Wednesdays off and drive 2 hours to go see my mom. She had leukemia.
Wow.
So that's what I was saying, teamwork. He stepped back so I could spend that time with her. It was 18 months of treatments, and
wow.
She died 2 years ago.
Wow, 2 years ago?
Yeah. Yep.
Wow. God bless you. God bless your children. God bless your whole family, and thank you for being here in the locker room.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Great.
If you know someone you feel has a special story to tell or life to share, please email Eric directly and he will reach out to you and or this individual, even if you think this person is you. And by the way, if you've enjoyed and feel the Daily Locker Room has served as an inspiration in your life, why not share it with a friend by sending them the daily message?